As I work, I spend the majority of days having conversations with people that are not there. 2 days ago, I explained to my mother how the translation program I was writing would greatly help me understand exactly what all this Aridan text I've been attempting to decipher actually means. My mother has been dead for 16 years. She was never actually interested in science to begin with. I'm unsure if I'm quite to the point of no return, but my stubbornness, which I got from her in the first place, will keep me here putting up with her until I find exactly where the vault is. Or until I drive myself so off the edge, I do not remember why I was doing this in the first place. This is exciting. I think I might strip naked and run around to celebrate, but I'll do it during the dim cycle, for fear of prying eyes. Before overloading and melting four of my computer's 13-qubit operators, my program was able to decipher quite a bit more than I had been able to understand before. It will take a few days to fix, but I was able to find many repeated instances of an event that takes place every 200 years. It's repeated many times with a symbol that looks not unlike a circle with an upside-down V in it. It's possible that this is the vault. And something about the vault happens every 200 years. Tonight, for dinner, I will have eggs.
First aid kit, and you won't regret it.
Need something? There are more important things to do here than chase after some fairy tale. The vault is not real.
If you're on a budget, TDR is always the way to go.
Come in. Have a look around.
Hey there! Welcome!
You keep yourself out of trouble.
get our feet out of the dust.
Come right in. I understand that believing in the improbable gives us hope. But if that vault existed, someone would have found it decades ago.
Again, there are more important things to do here than chase after some fairy tale. The vault is not real.
Anything like that?
Take a look.